Welcome. In this lecture, we are going to understand about wattmeter connection. Now, as I've already discussed that wattmeter is a instrument which is used for power measurement, and power is equal to a multiplication of voltage, current and power factor. So, if we simply include an ammeter and a voltmeter, then we will get the quantities of V and I, not cos phi. For that we have to use wattmeter specifically for AC power measurement. Now there are several components in wattmeter connection. First is CC. CC means current coil, and PC means pressure coil. CC or current coil serves the purpose of measuring current or as an ammeter. Now what we have read in ammeter, its resistance is small or less because it needs to allow the amount of current which is purely coming from the supply system and to pass through this current coil, so resistance should automatically needs to be less. That's why in diagram there is a less number of coil. Conversely, in pressure coil resistance is much higher or very high, so it has higher number of turns. It is as similar as like the voltmeter, which internal resistance is very high, so that very less amount of current should pass through it, because whenever we are connecting a load with the system, we always want that the current that is coming from the supply system, the major part should pass through this load, so that we get the maximum efficiency of our load, specifically the load which drives mechanical load. Clear? So voltmeter or pressure coil resistance always kept high. Now your question will be, why there is a disparity in connection between figure 1 and figure 2. Which connection? Pressure coil and current coil. In figure number 1, pressure coil is connected before current coil. Like here is a node. Suppose this is N1. And in figure number 2, current coil is connected before pressure coil. Like here. Suppose that it is node 2. So at the supply system, the current is first coming to current coil, then going to pressure coil, and then going to load. Now what will be the difference if we connect in this way our current coil and pressure coils? See, in figure number 1, when pressure coil is connected with current coil, then a current IP is passing through current pressure coil, then the load current, that is, this is the load current IL, that is equal to your current coil current, because load current coil is connected in series with the load. So if we consider this whole structure as our wattmeter, similarly in this diagram this is our wattmeter, then at figure number 1 our wattmeter will read power consumed at load plus power loss at current coil. Now your question will be, why? As I was saying that the load current is similar to current coil current. Now if we consider the current coil resistance as RCC, then the additional power loss at current coil is equal to or IL square RCC. This is the additional reading the wattmeter will read, and usually or obviously this is an error in the reading. Similarly, in figure 2, the wattmeter reading will be power consumed at load plus power loss at pressure coil. Why? Because the current that is read by this current coil consists of the current of pressure coil plus load current. So we can write here IC is equal to IP plus IL. So this wattmeter will include the loss in the pressure coil, that is supply voltage, suppose it's V square, and if this pressure coil resistance is RP, then it is additional V square by RP. This is also an error in wattmeter reading. So whatever the connection may be, there is always an error is included in our wattmeter reading irrespective of the connection. So wattmeter will read always higher compared to true power, because in both the cases this much of error is included. Clear? Now let us see an application of the concept that we have recently learned. Suppose an electrodynamometer type wattmeter has current coil with a resistance of 0.1 ohm and a pressure coil with a resistance of 6.5 kilo-ohm. Calculate the percentage errors while the meter is connected as current coil to load side and pressure coil to load side. So here we have the diagrams again. First case, current coil is at the load side. So here the current coil is at the load side, and in next the pressure coil is at the load side, as the pressure coil here is connected to this load side. Now what we need to calculate first, at figure 1, when current coil is connected to load side, the wattmeter will read this power consumed by the load plus current coil current square, that is IC, into the current coil resistance, that is RC. See, so our reading will be VI cos phi plus IC square RCC, that is equal to, according to the question, V is 250 volt and I is 12 ampere. That is 250 into 12 into 1, because the power factor is unity. Plus IC is here is equal to 12. Why? Because the load current is 12 ampere specified here in the question. So as I have said, IC is equal to IL, that is equal to load current, because current coil is connected with the load. So into RCC, current coil resistance is 0.1. So we have total power is equal to this much watt. This is the reading of the wattmeter connection for figure 1. Now what is the true value of power consumed by load? 3000 watt. That is equal to VI cos phi, because the load is consuming this much power only. So the excess reading is 14.4 watt. So our percentage error will be 14.4 divided by 3000. That is equal to measured value minus your true value divided by true value that we have already learned in our previous lectures, into 100. That is equal to 0.48% error will be there in your reading for type 1 connection. Now let us consider at the second case where pressure coil is connected to load side. So this is figure 2. What I have said, that the wattmeter will read power consumed by load plus power loss at pressure coil. So we can write here power consumed at load is equal to your VI cos phi, and power loss at load is equal to your v square by r p, so that we can write w is equal to like this. So our wattmeter reading will be 3009.6 watt. This is the reading the wattmeter will show. Now the percentage error is equal to measured value, that is minus true value, that is 3000 watt divided by true value into 100, that is equal to 0.32%. So whenever we are changing the type of connections, our error is also varying, though it is a very small amount of variation. In first case it is 0.48%, and in second case it is 0.32%, but there will be a variation. Clear? Now I am asking you a question. Can we make a connection or modification in these two type of connections, that is this is figure 2 and this figure 1, so that the reading for both conditions is equal? Mention your answer in the comment section below. Thank you.